few moments, you will be sorted into your houses. They are Gryffindor, Hufflepuff, Ravenclaw, and Slytherin. Your house will be like your family. Your triumphs will earn you points, any rule breaking, and you will lose points. At the end of the year, the house with most points wins the house cup.
It's true then. Harry Potter has come to Hogwarts. I'm Malfoy, Draco Malfoy. Think my name is funny, do you? I don't need to ask yours. Red hair and a hand-me-down robe. You must be another Weasley. You don't want to be making friends with the wrong sort, Potter. I think I can tell the wrong sort for myself, thanks. Ignore him. Come on, Harry. The sorting hat ceremony is about to begin. It's not a real ceiling. It's just bewitched to look like the night sky. I read about it in Hogwarts, the history.
Before we begin, I have a few reminders I wish to announce. The Dark Forest is strictly forbidden to all students. The third floor corridor is out of bounds to everyone who does not wish to die the most painful death. Thank you.
When I call your name, you will come forth. I shall place the sorting hat on your head and you will be sorted into your houses.
Harry, Ron, it's starting! I'll be a Gryffindor for sure. All my brothers are in Gryffindor. Whatever it is, you don't want to be a Slytherin. Why not, Ron? Well, my dad said that dark wizards come from Slytherin. I bet Malfoy will fit right in.
You don't know that, Ron. Maybe we can use data science to predict who is sorted into which house.
You're right, Hermione. The sorting hat is like a classification algorithm. My brother Percy is a prefect.
Look, he gave us some data from the second and third year students. Look, Hermione, this data set shows what each person's skills are for a range of subjects.
They are called input features. We can create a sorting hat classification algorithm to use prior knowledge from second and third year students to predict what house it will put us in.
Can't argue with that, Hermione. I saw some missing values in the dataset. How do we fix this?
Using a technique called multiple imputation. We can use the mice function in the mice package to impute missing values. M refers to the number of imputed datasets. In this case, it's 5. Maxit refers to the number of iterations taken to impute missing values. And here we have set 50 iterations. Method refers to the method used in imputation, and we have used predictive mean matching.
Amazing, Hermione. We fixed the missing value issues. Can we take a look at the relationship between features next?
Absolutely. We can use the ggpairs function from the ggally package to generate pairs plots. And we can assign color based on the four Hogwarts houses.
These plots look amazing. What do they tell us, Hermione?
We want to look at features that show an obvious separation of the four houses. For example, the features are Herbology, Defense Against the Dark Arts, Divination, Ancient Runes, Charms, and Flying. Now, we can split the dataset into the Train and Test datasets. We can use the Create Data Partition function from the Carrot package. We split the Train and Test datasets using a 70-30 ratio.
I guess we can now train the multinomial logistic regression model using the train dataset.
Yes, multinomial regression is an extension of binomial logistic regression. We need to use the multinomial regression to predict a Hogwarts house target feature which has 4 levels or 4 houses. Can we use the multinom function from the NNet package to generate the multinomial model?
Yes, try it, Harry.
Multinomial regression predicts the probability that a specific student is part of a specific Hogwarts house. Based on these results, we can see that students 1 and 2 are assigned to Hufflepuff, student 3 is assigned to Gryffindor, and student 4 to Hufflepuff, and so on. Can we use the model to predict values for the test or unseen dataset?
Yes, we can.
We can use the predict function to predict the Hogwarts house for the test dataset.
What's the results, Hermione?
Take a look at this classification table of the actual Hogwarts houses for the second and third year students versus the predicted houses. It looks like the predictions are pretty accurate. For example, the classification algorithm we built predicted 95 out of 98 Gryffindor students correctly. And we can also calculate the accuracy of the model using the sum function, which is 98% on the test dataset. That's right. Hey guys, I'm sorted into Gryffindor. Harry's up next.
Harry Potter.
Difficult. Very difficult. Plenty of courage. And there's talent. Oh yes. And the thirst to prove yourself. But where to put you?
Not Slytherin,
eh? Are you sure? You could be great, you know. Slytherin will help you on your way to greatness. No? Well, if you're sure, better be Gryffindor!
Yay! Whoop, whoop! Well done, Harry!